equation, and that partial differential equation again converted into algebraic equation to solve any type of problems. Like it may be a heat thermal related problem, it may be a structural related problem, or it may be a electromagnetic. So that's why it's a one of the universal approach to solve any type of problem. Why need to study this approach? What is the need? Because some method or MOM method, what is there, that is only applicable to the limited number of type of problem, like simple problem, simple in structure, simple in loading conditions. So, and also it is only mainly applicable to much linear types of problems. So if suppose in a practical conditions, it may be the complex shapes will be there, complex loading conditions there. In order to solve that, we are going to use this numerical technique to solve those type of problem in a approximate way. Again, keep this in mind, this will not give the accurate, it gives the approximate way. But classical approach will give the exact way. So based on this, as I told yesterday, pre-quiz knowledge required, sir. One is MOM concept required, basics, mathematics are very much required, heat transfer as well as fluid mechanics. So now today we are going to begin with the module one, that is introduction to finite element method. Okay, introduction. Various phenomena treated in science. So, and one more thing before going to start this model, what are the topics we are going to study? Yesterday I told. So here very important things we are going to discuss is what is FEM, what is the how to solve problem in using FEM approach, and what is the advantage, disadvantage, steps involved, and also we are going to deal with some other approach like numerical analytical technique like Rayleigh's method, Galkin method, and what is element, different types of element, interpolations, models, all those things. So that means all on main basics is included in this module one. That's why you should not miss any classes, especially on this module. If you miss it, you will not going to understand things. So that's why we are going to take it very slowly, because this is the one of the different subject which is not studied till now. So that's why what I'm going to planning is about. It will take time. It will take to make to understand. It take time. That too in online. I know that how much difficult. And most of things are here. Theory part is there, and some part of the numerical also there. So theory questions definitely almost is the repeated questions there. If you prepare the theory, definitely you can able to attend at least on 15 marks. So that's why we'll go into slowly first beginning. After that, in the second modulus, we are going to move fast. Okay. So let in the first concept what they are given in any subject. It's the introduction part. That is what we are going to discuss now. A various phenomena treated in a science and engineering are often described in terms of differential equation formulated by using their continuum mechanics models, solving differential equation various condition such as boundary or initial condition leads to the understanding of the phenomena and can predict the future of phenomena. Exact solution for differential equation however are generally difficult to obtain. So numerical methods are obtained to obtain approximate solution for a differential equation. So as I told here, they mentioned here, so various phenomena treated in science engineering are often described in terms of differential equation. So any type of structural problem you take it, any type of structural or it may be a thermal problem, it may be, we are going to use very basics, we are going to use governing equations like called as partial differential equation. What are those governing equation? You can go, we'll going to take it in the next after that. So like we are going to take a governing equations of different of applications like thermal fluid. Suppose if you take a fluid, Navier-Stokes is one of the very important, Bernoulli's equation is one of the governing equation. If you come to the structural, this one stress strain relations are very important one. Principal stress and strain, these are the governing equation. That's under partial differential equation is there. Suppose if the structure become more complex, this is therefore the partial differential also become more complex in nature. So in order to solve that partial differential equation, what we are going to use the classical approach, it will take lot of computation time and it is difficult to do it also. So therefore, in order to find the exact solution for the differential is nowhere possible. It is difficult. In order to obtain the solution for the differential equation for that complex structure, we are going to use numerical methods to obtain, not exact. Again, it is an approximate solution for them. So in that, FEM is one of the numerical method which is going to use perhaps the most popular numerical technique. There are different numerical techniques will be there. What those things, numerical technique, different types will be there, that will take into the next slides. The finite element method is perhaps the most popular numerical technique for solving the engineering problem. The method is generally enough to handle any complex shape or any geometry in any type of material property. That is very important. Any type of geometry you take, even any type of material you take, it may be a linear problem, non-linear problem, any type of boundary condition you take, any type of loading condition take, which is the FEM become the one of the popular numerical technique to find the solution for a differential, partial differential equation in a approximate way. So generally, generality of the finite element method fits the analysis requirements of today's complex engineering system and design, where closed form solution governing equations are usually not available. In addition, it is an efficient design tool by which designer can perform parametric design studies by considering various design cases like different shape, material and load, analysis them and then choose the optimum design. The finite element method is a numerical technique for obtaining approximate solution to a wide variety of engineering problems. The method is originated in the aerospace industries as a tool to study stresses in complex airframe structure. The method has gained increased popularity among both researchers and practitioners. See, especially this FEM is going to implement in the first beginning of the stages in the aerospace structure, because you know that in aerospace, there is a lot of complexity in the structure will be there, complexity in the loading condition will be there, complexity in the material will be there. So therefore, and there is a lot of component structure will be there, that each structure made up of different types of material. Therefore, in order to considering all those things using a classical approach is very difficult. So therefore, in those type of problem, they are going to solve using this type of technique they are implemented. So later on, it become like a very popular, and they are that FEM, it's going to be used in a entire in a other types of applications, in all application. In beginning, they are going to use in a aerospace, because that is one of the most in a mechanical field, most tough, complicated structure is the aerospace structure. That's right. So therefore, it is become now very popular and vital and more reliable to solve any types of complex problems and structure with that. So that is known as FEM. Got it? Introduction part, you got it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good. Now, as next, what we are discussing here, engineering problem for the solution. Suppose you take any problem, like you take a simple bar with a what you call a axial load, simple bar with a circular section, I'll say axial load. So that can be solved in a three way. What is the solution for that? That can be solved usually in a three way. What are the three solution will be there? One is called analytical method, one is called numerical method, and one more is called experimental method. Analytical method means that is our SOM approach. There are different analytical method is there. Especially very famous is the first one is the MOM or strength of material approach will be there. That will give the easy to classic, that is called classical approach, that is used to solve the problems in a 100% accuracy. Suppose what is the load? Stress is developing on that means load by area. Exactly you will get. So without any difficulty. And that's why it's give the 100% solution for that. And even numerical technique also we can solve it. And even by conducting an experiment, by applying the same, you take the same bar and with specimen with a made up of material, same material what they mentioned, and you can apply the load and you can calculate. That is what you've done in the material testing lab and all, correct? So compression load, tensile load, how the material will be behaves, how to stress strain you calculated. So that is the experiment method. So all these three we can use it for any type of problem. But come to the analytical method, it is has some limits, because this analytical method, which is applicable only to the which type of problem, it is only to the applicable to the simple type of problem, like it may be a beams, it may be a bars, it may be a shaft. So very simple problem with a simple loading conditions, which is what you have solved till now in a MOM as well as what you called in a DME. So those things we are going to solve using a classical approach only. Therefore, that will give the accurate result. Suppose you take a complex structure, you can see that figure here, you can see that it is a crane structure. It's a complicated one. Here it is simple one, jib crane, but this one is the complicated. You can see there are n number of bars will be there, n number of trusses components will be there, and here different types of combined load will be there. So therefore this has become complex structure. So you can able to calculate the result using analytical method, but it will take a lot of time, and that is a very, very difficult as a tedious job. So therefore for this we can easily calculate the result using a numerical technique as well experiment. So that is what you are discussing here, what are the differentiate between these three. So analytical method is a classical method, 100% accurate, closed from solution, applicable only for simple problem like cantilever beam, bars, etc. Numerical method is a mathematical representation, and also it is not accurate, it's approximate, and we are going to use some assumptions here, and we can apply the real life complex structure. Result cannot be believed blindly, certain results must be validated by experiment, and that is one more important. What we are calculating the numerical method, we can't say that is only the final result, that should be validated with the experiment method. Without validating that, no one will take that is the final conclusion. But whereas in analytical method, once you calculate it, no need to conduct an experiment. You can directly you can go through the result, and as per that you can design it. You can believe blindly believe there. But numerical method, what we are using is in approximate solution. What it will give, that's why you cannot directly believe that what result is correct. So you should validate with the experimental method. That is the one important. So what are the numerical methods are there? Like we mentioned here, FEM, BEM, FEM, FDM. FEM in the sense, finite element method. BM stands for boundary element method. FEM is the finite volume method, and FDM is the finite difference method. So what is those things, we'll take it in the next slides. In experiment method, what experiment method means, what actually the structure is there, same structure we are going to take it, and finally we are going to measurement means we are measuring like temperature, or it may be a stress, strain, deformation, all those things we are going to. But obviously it is time consuming will be there, and obviously experiment method is consumed a lot of money. That means very expensive. Applicable only to the physical prototype is available. If prototype is available, then only you can conduct experiment, otherwise it's not possible. This result cannot be believed blindly, and minimum 3 to 5. And that also, by one experiment, one trial itself, we can't believe again blindly. You should conduct minimum three to five tests on the prototypes, and finally you have to take the average result. So that should be there. And so like example, like strain gauges using a sensor, accelerometer, we are going to measure the strain, acceleration, speed, whatever it may be. So these are the three types of solution in the entire engineering process will be there. Either you can go for analytical method, numerical method, expert method. Especially experiment method is mandatory in industry side, because without testing they are never be going to be believe the results. And one more thing, yesterday what we are discussing is the design process. No, what is the first step? Hello,
yes, sir.
What is the first step in a design process,
sir? Surveying, sir.
Yeah, surveying in the market by identify the problem. How we can identify by surveying the market. After that,
planning, sir.
After that, we need to plan. Then after that,
conceptual design, sir.
Conceptual design, then detailed design. After that, detailed.
Manufacturing process.
Yeah. So here one small addition is there. Actually, yesterday I not told. In after the done the detailed design, they are going to conduct one prototype testing, must and should, because that prototype testing from that result they are going to validate with what you have calculated, like analytical method or numerical method, whatever it may be. They are going to validate. So they are conduct one prototype test. So once the prototype test results are valid, then only they are approved for the production. Otherwise, again the experiment result is not matching with your what you are expected, again they are going to redesign, changes in the material, or it may be structure, dimensions, all those things. Therefore after the detailed design, they go for one testing. It's a mandatory to make a one prototype testing. in that prototype testing, this all results are matched with the, what you have designed, then only final approval for the manufacturing will be take place. That is the one addition one you should add it. Please note on that. So after the prototype testing, then manufacturing, then again quality checking, and finally it goes to the what? Finally goes to where? Final step is what?
Quality checking, sir.
Quality checking, after that what is that?
Marketing.
Finally go to the marketing. So again, this is the same slide which is going to be explain about the difference between these three methods. So analytical methods, 100% is a classical approach, 100% accuracy, close from the farm solution you'll get it, and it's applicable for only for the simple one. Numerical technique is a mathematical representation and approximate assumptions will be there. Real life complex problem easily solved. So result cannot be believed blindly, as I told already. You need to conduct experiment to compare the result, and in experiment that accurate measurement you're going to take it, but time consuming as well as expensive also. So, and it result again cannot be believed. It 3 to 4 times minimum prototype should be done. So out of these three, what we are discussing about my subject, that is FEM. So it's an come to the which part, which type of method we are going to use in FEM, come to the which type of method. FEM method is a which type of method?
Detail. No, here we discussed
three solution, no method, analytical method, numerical method, experimental. So FEM, as I told in the beginning now, just now, which type of method is this one? Analytical method, or numerical method, or experimental method?
Numerical.
It's a numerical method. It's a numerical method we are going to use. That is FEM. So again, so we are going to take it now, numerical method. Close my door. So we are going to use the numerical methods. So say numerical methods is a kind of mathematical technique which is going to be used applied to the any complex structure, as I told. It's a completely a mathematical technique we are going to apply, like your Fourier series or Taylor series, or it may be a Gauss elimination method. All these things which is called as numerical approach, numerical methods will be there. So in that numerical method, there are eigenvalue problems, Gauss elimination method, Taylor series. So all this Fourier series, all these are called a numerical method. So this numerical methods, it is divided into two way. This is not numerical method. Yeah. So in numerical method, there are different types are there. 1 minute. Yeah. See, if you take any solution to the problem, there are three approach we said: analytical approach, numerical method, and experiment method. In that, if you leave it about the experimental one, if you take solution between analytical and numerical, what are the types are there? In analytical, there are two different types. One is called exact one. One is called approximate one. Again, in that analytical also, which is the exact one? That is called classical approach, like MOM or SAM. MOM in the sense that you know, SAM also it is same subject. One more name is called as for the MOM is SAM, strength of material approach. So that will give the exact solution. But in that analytical also, there are one more type, an approximate is there, that is known as Rayleigh's method, Galkin method. This is called analytical method. Again, in module 1, we are going to discuss about this, how to solve the problem using Rayleigh's method, Galkin method. So that will also give the approximate. These two method will comes in an analytical method. So again, you come to the numerical method. So this is also, obviously, there is no exact solution here. It's an approximate solution, it will only give. So what are the numerical methods out there? FEM, FDM, FEM, BM, energy method, etc. FEM in the sense that you know already, finite element method. that not EDM, that is FDM, this one. So FDM is nothing but finite difference method, finite difference method. FEM in the sense finite volume method, BM in the sense boundary method, and finally the energy method. So these are the around 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 types are comes under the numerical method. So that is what we are discussing here. The formulation for the structural analysis is generally based on the three fundamental relation: equilibrium, consecutive and compatibility. There are two major approach to the analysis. One is analytical and numerical. Analytical approach which leads to the closed form solution, which is effective case of simple geometry and boundary condition, loading as well as material property. However, in reality such cases is not arise. As a result, various numerical methods are evolved for the solving such type of problem, which are complex in nature. For numerical approach, the solution will be approximate when of these relations are only approximate satisfied. The numerical method depends only on the heavily on the process power of computer and is more applicable to the structure of arbitrary size. It is common practice to use approximate solution of differential equation as the basis of structural analysis. So this is usually done using numerical approximation. So this is usually done using a numerical approximation technique. The few numerical methods are commonly used as finite difference method, finite volume method, finite element method, boundary element method. Let me see. One minute. Okay. Let me see what are those methods. First one, FEA. Finite element method. It is also known as FEA, finite element analysis. Both are same. Finite element method as well as finite element analysis. Usually finite element analysis, FEA, where they are called means when you are going to solve the problem using a FEA software package, like it may be ANSYS, it may be a Natson pattern. When you are going to solve through the computer, usually that is called as FEA. So, but usually when you are going to solve through the theoretically, that is usually called FEM, but both are the same, no much difference. Okay, both are, it's called as FEM and FEA are both are same. FEM is nothing but finite element method. FEA is nothing but finite element analysis. So both name they are going to call it. So finite element method is a popular numerical technique used to determine the approximate solution for a partial differential equation. So applications are linear, non-linear, buckling, thermal, dynamic, fatigue analysis, any type of analysis you can do it. Okay. Yesterday I asked you the question, what is linear types of analysis? What is non-linear types of analysis? Are linear types of problem or non-linear types of problem? Can you tell me anyone? Linear and non-linear problems. What do you mean that? Which is that? Anyone know that? Don't know. FEM. Sorry, linear and non-linear. Hello, can you hear me? Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. See, linear types of problem means the material which obeys Hooke's law. And it has also the material having less number of strain. So that type of problems is called linear types of problem. Non-linear means the material behave like a non-linear behavior. That means more strain will be occur compared to the stress. So like larger deflection will be there compared to linear problem, more deflection. Suppose if you apply the load, same load. So for linear types of behavior of the material, it deflect less. But if you same load, if applied to the non-linear types of material, it deflect more. So that type of material is called as non-linear material. And for that, what you are going to analysis is called non-linear analysis or non-linear types of problem. Can you tell me example of non-linear materials which produce more strain or more deflection? Can you tell me some example? Suppose you apply the load, it will deflect more. Deflection is more, our strain will be more is there compared to the stress. Can you tell me?
Hello? Sir, spring.
Yes, okay. Material. I'm asking material. Spring is not a material, correct? But anyway, non-linear behavior is there. That is spring analysis, one of the non-linear analysis. That is correct only. Okay. Any other?
Rubber, sir.
Yes, exactly. So rubber, aluminium, especially rubber and all. So any elastic type of material you take it, elastomers, all these things are non-linear material. So because it takes more deflection or more strain will be there compared to the stress. So therefore, that type of analysis can be analysis of the or design of those things are very difficult because non-linear behavior means you can't predict how much it is strain is happening with respect to the load. It will take the deflection in a faster way. So therefore, that analysis through the analytical method is very difficult. So therefore, using FE approach, you can solve easily that. And buckling problem you can easily solve, thermal, dynamic, all these problem type of problem you can easily solve. So boundary element method, that is BEM. So it is also a powerful and efficient technique, a numerical technique to solve these especially acoustic problems. So related to the sound. So just like FEA, it required nodes and element, but only consider the outer boundary. So that difference is here. I will come to later about FEM. So here FEM, we are going to divide into like elements. But in boundary element, as the name in itself, suppose you take a circle is there. So it will not take the inside one. It will take only the periphery. Boundary only it will consider. It will calculate the result all across the only the boundary. Inside it will not calculate anything. So therefore it is called boundary element method. That is what they're saying here. Just like FEA, it also required nodes and element, but only consider the outer boundary of the domain. So when the problem is a volume, only outer surface are considered. If the domain of an area, then also outer periphery. It may be considered the plane element or it may be considered the volume element, only it will consider the border, that means boundary. It will calculate only across the boundary, not at the middle or way somewhere. Only at the across the boundary or periphery it will consider. That is known as boundary element method. Next one is the finite volume method, FEM. FEM method is representing the evaluating partial differential equation as an algebraic equation method used in many computation fluid dynamics packages. So this is mainly applicable to the when you're going to solve the fluid mechanics problem like turbine, compressor, aerodynamics. So suppose if the flight is moving against the air, how the air will be impact on that. In order to analyze all those things, they are going to use this type of finite volume method is more applicable there. Not structural problem, CFD, computation fluid dynamics. It is one of the latest technology which is going to in the numerical method use it to solve the all types of fluid mechanics types of problem they're going to use. So usually for that FEM approach they're going to use, that is finite volume method. And fourth one is the finite difference method, that is known as FDM. It uses Taylor series. So that you know already about Taylor series, no? I think you studied in a M4 or M3, Taylor series. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Taylor series, you know that, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
See, those Taylor series is one of the numerical method which is going to be used in a finite difference method to solve the differential equation to an algebraic, converted to algebraic equation. So therefore, here this FDM which is used in the thermal as well as CFD coupled problems. So not only fluid problem, thermal plus CFD, both combination type of problem can be solved using this FDM. So these are the various numerical technique is there. FEA, BEM, FEM and FDM. So out of this, we are going to only concentrate on the FEM method, which can be specially, which is FEM method, which is going to use specially for the this type of problem, like linear, non-linear, buckling, structural types of problem, which is very much famous, which is going to be used using a FEA method. So that only we are going to concentrate. So as I yesterday we discussed about the definition, that is what same thing is there. FEM method is a numerical method to solve the partial differential equation, and that partial differential equation is converted into algebraic equation form to solve the any type of structure using algebraic technique. So like now again, same questions is there here in a different way they are going to approach. What is FEA or FEM? As I told, FEA, FEM are both are same. FEA is known as finite element analysis. FEM is known as finite element method. So these word are same they are going to use. But usually FEA when they are going to call means when this problem is going to be solved using a computer, using help of computer, they are going to call as FEA. Using a theoretical approach, they are called as FEM. But both are same. So it is a numerical method, mathematical representation of actual problem, approximate method. The finite element reduces the degree of freedom from infinite to finite with the help of discretization process. So that is the main fundamental they are going to use here. If you take any structure, they are going to convert into discretization process they will do. That means they are going to convert into small, small, small pieces. So that is called as meshing, and that process is called meshing, and each piece is called as elements. So that principle they are going to use in a FEM to convert the infinite degree of freedom to the finite degree of freedom. So let me see what is the next slide. I will come to the degree of freedom later. So here F stands for finite, E that is reduce the degree of freedom infinite to finite, E stands for element. All the calculation are made at the limited number of points known as nodes. The entity of joining nodes and forming a specific shape such as quadrilateral or triangular or element method. Three methods are to solve the engineering problem. So we are going to use here very important in entire FEM three types of word we are mainly use. One is called element, one is called nodes, one is called mesh. What is elements? The domain of the physical problem is discretized into small, small pieces. That is known as finite elements. Example, you can see this is called ladder, and this is what is the structure. This one you can see. What is this called? What is this called? What is this one?
Ladder.
This is ladder. What about this one? Right side one. You can able to see the cursor? You can't. Hello. Can you able to see the cursor?
We can, sir. We can see.
You can. Okay, fine. What is this one called? What is the structure?
Aeroplane, sir. Rocket or aeroplane.
It is not an aeroplane. It is actually fighter jet. Okay. So now what you can see here. So flight is a one complete domain. That they, what they've done is they are going to divide. They are going to discretize into small, small pieces. You can see small, small pieces they do like a grids. You can see like it's called grids. So this small, small pieces, what you can see, even the ladder also going to divide into like this small, small pieces. So what is this small, small pieces is called as what? Elements. So one more, what we are going to use here, very important one is nodes. So what is node means? The elements are connected at points. You can see this is the element which is connected here. So this is one element, this is one element. These two elements are connected at these points. So you can see what is the orange color, you can see that highlighted point is called a nodes. So node is a point which connected the elements together. So that is known as a nodes. So next, assemblage of elements means when the small, small pieces are there, elements are there, that if you assemble it, and that is called as a mesh. Now you can see in this structure, entire what is the element, small, small pieces are there, that they are going to assemble and look like this. And this is called as a mesh. So these are the three main word we are going to use in an entire FEM. So this is called FEM entities. One is called element, nodes, and mesh. So what is element means? When the given structure is discretized into small, small pieces, and each small piece is called as a finite element. And what is node means? When the finite elements, the small, small elements are connected together at one point, and that point is known as a node. And assemblage of elements, total elements together, if you assemble it, then what is that called as mesh? So mesh, finite element mesh. So meshing is the process of discretization of the physical geometrical domain into a small pieces. Suppose you take, this is the geometrical domain. So the geometrical entities, can you tell me what are the geometrical entities are there? Suppose you have to draw this ladder. Can you tell me what are the geometrical entity you are going to use? What is the thing we are going to use? One is called points. Then one is called lines. These two are the geometrical entity you are going to use. Correct? In order to draw the ladder. Correct now?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Hello?
Yes, sir.
In order to draw the any geometry entity, if you take it, you have to use one, what is points and lines to draw that, or curve to draw that. So therefore, that is called as the geometrical entity. So that geometrical entities are, when you are going to do the meshing process, that converted to a finite element entity. So what are those finite element entity means? One is called elements, one is called nodes. So all the lines are converted into elements, all the points are converted into nodes. So this discretization process is known as a meshing process. So these are the three very important entity we are going to use. So that is the main principle behind this here. So what is given structure is there, let it be any size. They are going to divide into small chota pieces. So that pieces is known as, small pieces is known as element. And these elements are connected at one point, that is called as nodes. So therefore, assemblies of these nodes and the elements is called as a mesh, element mesh. So therefore, the finite element mesh is represented by an algebraic equation to solve for unknown for at nodes. So here, each elements what we are going to there. So at each node, they are going to apply the numerical, what you call governing equation, that is using a numerical technique. They are going to solve the what is the unknown at each point, what is the displacement at this point, what is the strain at this point, what is the stress at this point. Same thing here, all at each node, they are going to solve the unknowns. So the nodal unknowns are values of the physical problems are calculated. The nodal unknowns may be displacement, structural problem. It may be a temperature when related to the heat transfer problem. It may be a velocity or pressure when related to a fluid flow problems. So at each node, they are going to calculate the unknowns with respect to the application. Suppose if you are going to use a structural problem, then go to calculate what is the displacement, what is the stress, what is the strain or reaction. Suppose if you are using a heat transfer problem, then you are going to calculate at the each point what is the temperature, what is the Q value, total heat transfer. So all those things. Suppose if you are solving the fluid flow problem, then you're going to calculate at each point what is the pressure, what is the velocity, what is the acceleration, all those things. So therefore, although FEM solution is not an exact, the solution can be improved by using more elements to represent the physical problem. As you more, if you divide it, you'll give the almost closer to the exact value. So more the elements if you divide, and depending upon the size, your results matters. So therefore, that will affect finally the final result. So therefore, how we are going to divide, it matters a lot in the FEM. That is the first step. We're going to discuss what is the steps involved in the FEM. So main fundamental principle is this much only in the FEM. What is the given domain is there, that convert into a, discretize into small pieces. That small piece is known as elements. So all these elements connected to at the one point, each point is called as nodes. All these elements are combined together is called as a mesh. This is very important. You can see this in this figure. This is called a coarse mesh and this is called fine mesh because here size is more. This is the profile, given profile or domain that they are discretized like this. Therefore, the sizes of each elements are more here, or area are more. But when your same element, same domain is discretized like this in a small pieces, and this is called as a fine mesh. Technically, this is what they are going to use in entire FEM. If the more larger the size element they divided with a lesser element, then it is called coarse mesh. If sizes is less, more the elements are divided, then that is called as finer mesh. Suppose you taken, as I told here, your accuracy depend upon the how we are going to be divide the elements. Suppose you can take an example of your circle. Suppose I need to divide this circle with a 3 line they divided, 4 line they divided, 6th line, 8th line. Which line will give you are divided like this? Now, can you tell me which discretization process which gives the closer value, which represent the actual domain. Three lines, four lines, or six line, or eight line will which line which represent a profile of the circle. Can you tell me? Which one will give the which line? Here I divide into three, four, six line. Which one? Sorry, six and eight. Which discretization process which give the meet the same profile of the closer to the this one actual one?
Eight
lines. If you divide it, it is almost equal to the. It cover the same circle. Here you can see more gaps are there. This gaps is represent the errors. You can see this gaps is represent the error. But here this gaps are less. If you divide it further, 10 element, 12 element, 30, 40, 100, it will take the smooth curve formation will be take place. So therefore you can see in this curve graph, number as the more the number of lines increases, the exact answer also you'll get. At one state, it become constant. You'll get the same one. So therefore, dividing process is very important. How you are going to dividing and how many elements you are dividing, it matters the final result in the entire FEM process. So that is very, very important process here. So therefore, one more thing here, you can see if you use more the elements, it will take a lot of computation time and result will be accurate. So that is the thing. So, but if you use the lesser the element, obviously solution time is less, but result is not accurate. So that is the thing. So here the main thing is with a minimum time, we need to get the approximate solution, which is closer to the exact solution. Like that you have to divide it. That is the very important one. So you can see in this one more figure, there is a curvature is there, fillet. They are divided into two elements here, four elements, eight elements and 16. So you can see when you use the 16 element, it will matches the almost the same profile of the exact this curvature. So that is the one. So that will give the exact result. Otherwise, it will not give the exact results. So therefore, meshing process matters a lot here. That will improve, depends upon your accuracy, depends upon the meshing process. Understood? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
hello.
Sir.
This is about the basic fundamental principle in the entire FEM, what we are going to use. So in this slide, what we are going to discuss is background or history of the finite element, how this developed from past to present. First, this coin is FEM coin is implemented. So the method is implemented in 1941 by Aronnikoff and McHenry, using lattice 1D element to solve the stresses in the continuous solid. They are done. Second, after the 1943, Courant, the name of a scientist, he introduced stresses in the variational form. Piecewise interpolation form there is used to solve the problem. After that, 1953, Levy, he introduced the stiffness method or displacement method to solve the problem. After that, in 1954, Argyris and Kelsey used matrix method to solve using matrix method to solve the structural problem. In 1956, Turner used 2D element to solve the problem. In 1960, Clough, you introduced the coin of FEM. Till that, there is no FEM name. After the 1960 only, the Clough is the first person introduced the term called as finite element. Till that, they are not called as any finite element method. They are just called as numerical method. But he introduced that in 1960, this name called a finite element method. In 1961, Meloche is used bending element method, matrix stiffness matrix method to solve the problem. 1965, Clough and Rashid and Wilson, both all these three together, they saw introduced one more special type of elements is known as axisymmetric element. In 1965, Archer introduced FEM method to solve dynamic analysis. 1969, Sajabo and Lee both introduced weighted residual formulation to solve the problem. In 1970, Zenkewicz and Parekh introduced transit field problems to solve using this FEM method. In 1976, Belashchikov find the techniques to solve the nonlinear dynamics problem using FEM method he introduced. So after that, same thing. In 1972, Woden introduced one book that called as Book on Nonlinear Nonlinear Continuum to solve the nonlinear types of problem. In 1997, new elements are developed and converges studies. The development of supercomputers are take place after 97 and use the computer to solve these problems they are going to introduce. In 1970, FEM are applicable to a wide range of engineering problems. In 1970, the most commercial FEM software packages are introduced, that is Nastran and Firestone. See, in 1970, the first FEM approach using a computer they solved, that is software are introduced by NASA. You know that NASA, no? They are implemented the first FEA approach using a computer. They developed one program known as Nastran and Patron to solve the aerospace structure. Once it is succeeded, they commercially released to the market to their software. Initially, they are not just, they developed the software and they are using themselves to solve the aerospace problem. Once it is successful, then what they done, they commercially they released to the market to that software, that is known as Nastran, Patron. After that, there are so many software schemes, Abacus, Ansys. So, so many are there in the market till now, till today, to solve the problems of using FEM approach, a numerical method. So after that, 1918, algorithms and electromagnetic applications. Till that, only structural problems they're going to solve. After the 1918, they developed one program to solve electromagnetic types of problem, fluid flow type of problem, thermal analysis. Till that, only they are going to solve the problems using a structural problem like stress strain. To find out that only they are going to use it. After the 1980, they developed the, there is a, you know, the development take place in the computer. They're going to make it improve the speed of the computer with the help of the computer and with the developing the new type of programming. They are going to use this FEA technique to solve the other types of applications problem like fluid flow problems, thermal analysis problem, biomedical problem, all these things they are developing now. So till now in the market, there are so many FEA package software is available, which is used to can use for different types of application. So that will take up when you're going to start the lab. We'll see that what are those packages of the software that will take care. So this is about the history background of the development of FEA. Now, these two are the one of the important questions if they're usually in exam, sometime it will come. Now we got to know what is classical approach. We got to know what is FEM, different types of numerical techniques like FEM, FDM, FEM, all those things. Now here in these two slides, what we are discussing, what is the time? Okay. What you are discussing? 10:27, no, not 11. Who is the next hour?
Java.
Next hour, who is?
Java.
You got the link?
Java.
You got the link?
Yes, sir.
We'll continue in the afternoon session. This one, in the afternoon session, we are going to discuss very important thing like what is the difference between classical method, FEM method, and difference between FEM and FDM method, application, advantage, disadvantage, steps in the FEA, all those things we are going to discuss in the afternoon session. Maybe time after that 2 o'clock. Okay, I'll let you know before half an hour. So today I will not miss the afternoon class. Please everyone attend the class without fail, because we are going to discuss very important thing. So that is steps involved in the FEA, all the new, especially the examination theory part we are going to discuss in the afternoon session. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay. 1 minute, I will take a screenshot of the people. Let's see. Okay. 23 members. 1 minute.